This video demonstrates the steps to install and run PiVision 2020. It is divided into the following sections. Navigate to the location on your computer where you have PiVision Install Kit downloaded. Remember, before you install PiVision here, you need to run the installation as an account that is in the local administrators group. Right-click the install file, and then click Run as Administrator. Extract the files to a location of your choosing. When the process is complete, you will see a list of components that will be installed. Notice that one of the components is Microsoft.NET Framework 4.8. This will likely require a restart of the machine. Click OK to continue. When the .NET Framework install is complete, click Finish, and then click Restart Now to reboot your machine. After the machine reboots, enter the default asset server and default data server in the prompts and click Next. You can specify a custom location for the PiHome installation directories or keep the default C drive location. The installation process will continue. Next, we will begin the PiAF Client 2018 SP3 Patch 3 installation. Click Next. Decide whether you want to participate in our Customer Experience Improvement Program and then click Next. You can optionally enable the Management plugin feature by clicking here. Click Next to continue. If you do not have Microsoft Excel installed on this machine, you will see a message here to let you know that PiBuilder will not be installed since Excel is not available. Click Install. The final part of the install is the PiVision installation wizard. Click Next. Click Continue to acknowledge that you will comply with the laws, rules, and regulations for cookies. The next part of the process checks for any missing required Windows features. Leave the Install Missing Windows Features Now option checked. Click Continue. In this pop-up, click OK. Again, decide whether you want to participate in our Customer Experience Improvement Program, and then click Next. Click Next again. Since we just installed the web server, we only have the default website listed here. If you have an existing web server, you can select your website here if you are not using the default website. Click Next, and then click Install. After the process completes, click Finish. Then, click Next. Our machine now requires a reboot, so we will click Yes to restart the machine now. Once the machine has been rebooted, you can see that the PiVision 2020 setup was successful. Click Close. Close Server Manager. PiVision 2020 is now installed. We need to make sure that the PiVision application pools are running under the correct account in the Internet Information Services Manager. In the IIS Manager, click the web server and then click Application Pools. Here we can see the Admin, Service, and Utility application pools. Right-click one of them and then click Advanced Settings to change their identity. Scroll to the Identity Settings, double-click it, and select Custom Account, click Set. Enter your username and password, click OK, and then click OK again. Verify that Enable 32-bit applications is set to false. Click OK. Repeat these steps for the remaining app pools. When you're finished, your app pools are running under the custom domain account. In the IIS Manager, click the web server, and then click Sites to display the list of websites on your machine's IIS server. Locate the site that has the PiVision application installed under it. By default, and in our case, this is Default Website. Click Bindings. In the Site Bindings dialog box, click the HTTPS row, and then click Edit. In the Edit Site Bindings dialog box, click the drop-down list below SSL Certificate and then select a different certificate which will be bound to the port selected in this binding for your IIS website. The certificate we selected is trusted by browser clients and will prevent certificate warnings from occurring when users visit PyVision. Click OK. We have now verified that we have the right permissions and certificate, and we have successfully installed PyVision on this machine. From here, you will finish configuring PyVision.